Hello, welcome at Tech Talk episode 11. Also here, we will try to answer as many questions as possible that you left in the comments. The first question is about VE.Bus BMS. And the question is it possible to connect only the Cerbo GX to the VE.Bus BMS version 2 without the MultiPlus? Well, of course that's possible, but it's a little bit of a waste because in the VE.Bus BMS version 2, there's also the digital communication for the MultiPlus to enable DVCC, for example. If you don't want to use that because you don't have a MultiPlus or whatever, then of course you can better use a small BMS because that one is also giving you the contacts allowed to charge and allowed to discharge and will not have the digital communication. The second question is about using a generator. The question is, the output of the generator is often not stable or doesn't have a nice sine wave. If I connect the generator to the MultiPlus, will the output be cleaner? Well, basically, the input and the output of a MultiPlus will be connected when the generator is running. That means there will not be any effect on the sine wave itself or the voltage level. But if the charger starts charging, it will clean up a little bit of the sine wave of the generator. But basically, what comes in is also what goes out. So there's no difference there. The third question is coming from Germany. And the question is, I'm from Germany and we have very high energy prices. One way to reduce the cost is to have an exchange electricity tariff. When will Victron have software ready for series production? Well, luckily, this week we introduced Dynamic ESS. And Dynamic ESS is a software feature which enables you to make a plan on your consumption and also on your harvesting of energy. And then the software will decide when to buy and when to sell your energy to the grid, if you're allowed to do that. If you're not allowed to sell energy or not allowed to buy energy at certain times, you can also make these settings differently. Dynamic ESS is basically looking at your load for a system over a while, then also is looking at the most likely to be harvest energy for the coming day. And looking at the tariffs, it makes a plan per day on your energy consumption. So basically what the Dynamic ESS does, it makes a plan which is using your energy as optimal as possible. If you want to try out Dynamic ESS, it's free of charge and you can enable it on your VRM portal. Simply make all the settings there, fill in the calculation what your energy provider is giving you on cost price, and also of course of the cost of your batteries and the write-off of the batteries, and then you can try out what the Dynamic ESS does in your situation. The next question is about lithium batteries. The question is, can you tell me how I calculate the runtime of a lithium battery 48 volt 15 kilowatt battery running at a 1 kilowatt resistance on a 230 AC power? Well, basically, of course, the theoretical calculation is divide the consumption by the energy that you have. So if you have 15 kilowatts and you're using 1 kilowatt an hour, you should last for 15 hours. That's not completely true in real life because there are losses. Your inverter has losses and also the whole distribution from your battery energy to your inverter, there are some losses. Besides that, also your battery, which is 15 kilowatt hour, is most likely not able to supply that whole 15 kilowatt hour and is limited to, let's say, 90%. So theoretically, it's 15 hours. Normal life, I would say it's 13, 14 hours max. The last question is about the mains detector. This is a mains detector. The question is, will it also work with two MultiPluses in parallel operation, master-slave situation? Well, basically, the mains detector is a device which you connect in or near the multi and connect to the BMS. And what it actually does is it switches off the multi completely when you have a low battery or you have switched off the battery itself, so that the power consumption from the multi will not drain the batteries any further. So basically, every unit in your system needs a mains detector to be able to switch off that power reduction. Thank you for watching this episode of Tech Talk. If you have any questions for yourself, please leave them in the comments bar below and I will try to answer them in the next episode.